Okay, now in today's video, we're going to go over deception. And what I mean by deception is something that you may see on different levels of FIFA is, for example, if you look one way and then you shoot that way, are you actually going to go that way? But what you find sometimes in like the top tier divisions, the elite divisions, sometimes even pro level, is a player would, for example, look up to Ronaldo as looking to the right hand side and actually shoot that way. And this is what I like to call the whole deceptive argument. And it's something that I actually quite enjoy. Part to play with FIFA is how to outsmart your opponent, how to deceive. And I thought the best way I can explain this is in doing this via penalties. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to connect my controller just so you can see. This is how I do it normally. So I'm just going to connect my controller. And that way you're going to see exactly what buttons I'm pressing. So what would happen is, typically speaking, you should be able to see the penalty. Yeah, you can. Okay, so I'll kind of go back and explain this, right? So how this works is... when you're trying to take, let's say, for example, if you're new to the game, we all know when you start FIFA, most people, I would say, after some time, understand how penalties work. If you don't know, basically the direction you look at, you aim that way, and then you shoot, and if you and the ball will go that way. So you can technically see where your opponent is going. But, you know, obviously, as people play this game more and more, they're going to realize, oh, my opponent. So, like, if you, let's say, I'm just going to, kind of not stereotype, but just hypothesize here that an average player in Division 10, they will look to left-hand side, shoot that way, and that is it. So that is the easy way of just understanding where the opponent goes. Now, what I find, I would say, is Division 6 about Division 5, this is where people go the opposite. So when I'm playing foot champs, I would normally test that player out for the whole game, and I will kind of judge what level they are. So when it comes to, for example, penalty situation, let's say, for example, I'm winning, let's say 2-1 or 1-1 against my opponent, but I know he's playing very defensive, he or she, and they're playing very well. 9 times out of 10, if I want to try to outsmart that player, I would, for example, look to go one way and then go the other way. Now that is the so-called the easiest thing. But what happens is, I'm just saying as in base levels, but let's say someone in Division 3 onwards, they might know, oh, if you look that way, that's the way that you're going. And then if you, for example, go that way, most people, they obviously go the opposite way. So that's when the deception really kicks into play. So, for example, what I do, if I'm in the elite division, 9 times out of 10, if someone is looking one way, I think of it like they're probably not going to go the opposite way. So in the elite level, the way that I do it is if someone is looking towards the right-hand side, in my opinion, they're probably going to go to the right hand side to basically play like a double deception on me, because they want me to think I'm going to the left. So I might actually, that's why I think I'm quite consistent in penalties, is because I try to understand the patterns of what goes on. So that is an example of deception that's used. And then you have, for example, the real top tier players. And again, a lot of you guys probably know this because you watch videos, but let's say the average player that doesn't, maybe like one of my friends, they play FIFA, they don't watch any of my videos. They probably even know I do this, but if I did make a video, for example, on for example, the penalties, they might not know how to make it, but from their experience, they know how to bury it. But they would, for example, take a shot and then take a aim during the run-up. So you probably know if you take a shot and then you move the left analog stick after during the run-up, you can't see the head movement. So that is when the whole deception comes in. And that is why I genuinely enjoy penalties. Yes, it's random, but I enjoyed the deception argument. You know, I always think in my head, how many times is someone going to go, you know, if you go to the right-hand side twice, what's the chance you're going to go to the opposite side? It's very, very, very high. And that is why most of the time I win penalties. But that is the whole point of just deception in general. Another way you would see it is, for example, more commonly on the top tier level is down the wing. Now, we all know the meta is basically to get down the wing and do some sort of trickery to get inside the box. But the good thing that if you have that ability, if you have different, even if you have one skill move, is to use it to your advantage. You know, if you, for example, do a step over or you do a dummy and you go to the right hand side like 2 times, what is the chance you're going to go then to the inside? And it just takes that one chance, that one small chance to beat your opponent. Because don't forget, when you're defending, if someone is down the wing, you have to make it. And this is why when I teach you to defend, I always say hold your ground and defend the angle towards goal. Because if you know this player is going down twice down the right hand side, but he or she goes once on the inside, and if you go 2 times and then a 3rd time you commit that way, That third way is enough for your opponent to score. And that is why when I say you defend the angle towards goal. And that way, even if he does, you can then react thereafter and then you can at least block the shot towards goal. If the opponent is, of course, closer to you, you can then take a risk and go forward and tackle. And that is like kind of part in part with deception. Now, a lot of people, they use deceptive tactics, but they don't actually think about it. So even probably you probably use it, but you don't think about it. For example, you may think, oh, you know what, let me try to go left this way. Okay, didn't work. You know what, let me try to go right that way. Now, there's a couple of things that I say are very effective, and this is why I advocate a player that's got a five-star weak foot. For me, every striker, so I play Griezmann, Ribery, Eusebio, Ginola, Ben Yedder, all those players have a five-star weak foot. It's the ability to go on either foot. You see, if you've got someone who's got a four-star weak foot, it's much easier to predict which way they're going. So with Ronaldo, for example, I know nine times out of ten, Ronaldo either did one of the following, is that he would either go like this and take a shot across goal, or he would try to get a shot off on the right foot. So when let's say I'm defending him, I'm just going to put this in blue. What I might do is I might overcommit on the right-hand side and try to force this player to go on the left. So if he does, he'll be on the outside and I can try to force him to take a shot on his left foot on the awkward angle. That is why I advocate, and if you've been watching my video since FIFA 19 day one, I've always said to you, five-star weak foot is the most important thing. I would rather have a player that's, for example, not got, let's say, the best of stats, but better off, I'd rather have lower stats than a five-star weak foot. So instead of 99 finishing, I'd rather have 94, put 100 of them, and then put the five-star weak foot on. And the reason for this is, if you just take it in terms of basic maths, think of the weak foot. I think it's 85% of the final stat. I'm not 100% sure. I used to think it was 4/5, but I think they mentioned a weak foot is 85 with his 4-star. Don't quote me on this one. This one I can't confirm for sure, but I believe it's 85% of your stats. So if you have, for example, let's say you got 100, just to keep maths a bit easy, for me anyway, 100. And let's say, for example, then you then take 85% of it, then you're going to have 85 shooting. So even if a player has 100 finishing, which is technically impossible, they'll have 85. So can you imagine an average player that's got 90 finishing? Then you're now going to have 85% of that. So that is why I say a five-star weak foot on either side is very, very important. And that is one of the good deceptive tactics. Now, the second thing you can do is that the agility and balance of a player. The quicker they can turn, it's easier for you to maneuver into a space, because if your opponent sidesteps one way, you can basically counter that and then go the other way. You have to wait for your opponent to commit. And as I said, don't forget, 9 out of 10 times, most people when they defend, they don't know how to defend and they end up running towards you. When they run towards you, I get excited because I'm thinking, okay, now I can take a touch away and then I can go around. The hardest thing for me to do, I tell you honestly, the hardest thing to beat is when an opponent puts a controller down or they use the running jock and they just stand still. Because even if I find a small gap, I then have to take a shot through that gap and hope that A, his defenders don't stop it, which is like 50% chance. And then you have the miraculous goalkeeper that just saves everything in FIFA. So that is the whole idea behind deception. So as you go on, there's going to be a lot of deception. How can you improve your levels of deception? Now, what I like to do is kind of do this thing where I will do something twice deliberately to outsmart my opponent. So let's say, for example, if I'm using a player lock, I may use the player lock to get a player inside the box. But the third time, I may use it deliberately to pretend to go to the second guy, but I actually then switch to the third guy. So I'll do the same action twice inside the game, and then the third action would be the successful one. Now, does this mean that when you're on a clear chance in front of goal, you should start messing around and waste that chance? No. When you're in front of goal, you take the shot, you do what you got to do. I'm talking about, for example, if you're down the wing, for example, like here, I could, for example, do a fake shot, stop, turn back. So for those of you who don't know, my biggest rotation is go down the wing, do a fake shot, stop, pass it back, and then go all the way back to the CDM, if possible, to the striker and try to get the shot across goal. I may do that 3 times in a row, but I might, for example, the third time I then do a fake shot stop. Instead of going backwards as I normally do, I'll do a fake shot stop. And I could do chain with Lacroqueta, or I could do a fake shot stop and then do an Elastico. Now, there's two reasons why this is important. Number one, if it works, you're through. Number two, if it doesn't work, it changes the opponent how they defend. A lot of players, they do the same thing also without realizing because of pressure. They do the exact same thing every single time. Try to mix. Another good example is when you get the ball into your striker. One thing that even I have a bad habit of doing as well is I keep doing the same thing because I know it just works. But sometimes what I try to do is a very bad habit is when I play someone who's maybe not the best, I try to outsmart them and I mess the chance. Like if you watch my stream, you'd probably know sometimes it happens quite a lot. I try to out, like I will think, for example, this player is going to move the goalkeeper, but he might not. And I might try to outsmart them and I might outsmart myself. So these are all things you just have to bear in mind. One of my favorite things is goalkeeper movement. I, for example, only move my goalkeeper once or twice inside the game if I know it's guaranteed. So for example, like here, if my opponent is saying he's going to take a shot across goal, I would move my goalkeeper here because 9 times out of 10, should I say, that goalkeeper is going to make that save if that shot's going out. Unless that's a high-powered green time shot, the goalkeeper is going to save it. But there could be one odd occasion where that player might go near post. So these are all the things you got to equate. I see too many players, even when I look at gameplay back, I see they move the goalkeeper once one time, and the second time, they do the exact same thing. And if your opponent's in the exact same situation, you got to think about it smartly. Maybe you move them just a little bit, or maybe move them a little bit the opposite way. Maybe you don't move them at all, but try not to make the same repeated mistakes. Especially with goalkeeper movement. This is one of the key areas. I think people that unnecessarily move the goalkeeper. Now, bringing the goalkeeper out with triangle or Y, that is something else. I'm just talking about holding the right analog stick down and moving the goalkeeper. That is exactly what I'm referring to. But that's just kind of just a bit of an example of in terms of deception. Just a few things that I mentioned. Just my general rule of thumb. Two things, deliberate. Third thing, you use him. Use it to take him. Don't use it in a clear box, but use it like down the wing. When it's a 50-50, and I can guarantee your opponent will then change the way they defend. That's the key. If you have a 5-star weak foot as well, especially inside the box, it changes the psychology of defending completely. It's not just used on a pro scene. A lot. If you look at all top tier players, no one uses a 1 or 2-star weak foot. You just can't use a 2-star weak up front. It's not even good enough. Maybe back in FIFA 18, I used to use Gareth Bale and Cristiano Ronaldo up front. That's different. But nowadays, in my opinion, with how finishing is, how amazing goalkeepers are, you know how bad finishing is this game. I think you need that 5-star weak foot. But that's just kind of my just take on deception. Outsmarting your opponent. Hope you kind of took something away. Don't forget, 2 fake, 1 correct. Anyway, don't forget, if you want to get better at FIFA, you can come to my FIFA School Series, patreon.com/NeilGuides. Link is down below in the description. Thanks for watching. And of course, I'll catch you next time. Peace out.